वेलकम बैक एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू द टॉपिक सेक्टर्स ऑफ इंडियन इकोनॉमी। सो इन लास्ट क्लास वी डिस्कस अबाउट द पब्लिक सेक्टर, द सेक्टर विच आर रन बाय द गवर्नमेंट, वेयर गवर्नमेंट प्रोवाइड्स ऑल द सर्विसेज आर कॉल्ड द पब्लिक सेक्टर। एग्जांपल एयर इंडिया, रिजर्व बैंक ऑफ इंडिया। All such services, all such sectors or companies or institutions which are owned and run by government are known as the public sector. And private sector includes all the business companies run by an individual or a group of people are known as the private sector. For example, you have Vodafone, which is a private company. Tata is a private company. So we have this is called as the private sector. Now on the basis of employment, sectors can be divided into organized and unorganized sector. In organized sector, people have assured work and regular terms of employment. For example, their works are assured, they have a guarantee, they have a proper system of work, they have attendance, they have salary, monthly salary, they are given salary slips, they are well documented, everything is according to the government norms, there are documents pertaining to their employment, and even if they are supposed to leave, they are given notification, they are paid payment in advance, payment is done on time. So such kind of sector where the job is organized, where job is proper, where job is given according to the terms of government, norms of government, where rules are followed properly, such kind of sector is known as the organized sector. An example, you have here banking, police, all such things are come under organized sector. Now we are going to discuss about unorganized sector. Now these sectors consist of jobs which are of small level and they are not under the control of government. The pay is not sufficient, the pay is not regular, there is no job security, you might be thrown out anytime, there is no guarantee for job, payment is very less, there are no facilities such as medical facilities or sick leaves, casual leaves, there are no vacations, no such facilities. So in this kind of sector there is no control of government, so people suffer a lot. For example, you are seeing a lady who is working as a mason here, who is carrying the bricks. Now this lady won't be given enough wages to run her house. Mostly such people tend to live a life of poverty as their wages are very less. So the sector where the government rules are not followed, the employment where the government rules are not followed are known as the unorganized sector. So in India we still have a lot of unorganized sector which leads to the unemployment. Now how will you define unemployment? When a person is willing to work at the prevailing wage rate but fails to get a job is called unemployment. This means a person is willing to work, he has the thought of working, he wants to work but he is not getting the job. Such situation is known as unemployment. So types of unemployment we have seasonal, disguised, structural, cyclical and frictional. So these two unemployment, seasonal and disguised, you would have already studied in your earlier classes. So we'll go according to the topic one by one. The unemployment which generates due to the variation in season is called seasonal unemployment. These unemployment are mainly dependent on season. So if a particular season goes, the person becomes unemployed. For example, farming, harvesting, people who are occupied in harvesting of the crop. So after the harvesting season, they tend to become unemployed. So such a condition is known as seasonal unemployment. Moving ahead, when more than required number of people are working in the same place, this is known as disguised unemployment. Let us assume the room you are sitting is a piece of land. So that room, to harvest that room, two people are more than enough. But imagine five people are working in the same room to harvest the same amount of crop. Now you might say that the work may take less time to complete, but practically, economically, it is of no use, as the same amount of output will be given when the work is done by two people. The output will not vary. Hence, there will be no increase in economy. So, when more than required number of people are working in the same job, this is referred as disguised unemployment. So in your room, instead of 5, if 2 people are working and 3 people are employed in secondary or tertiary sector, so they will bring extra income from outside, which will add to the increase in economy of your family. In similar way, if more than required people are working in the same place, that won't be beneficial for the economy. Instead of that, some people should work in the primary sector and others should go and settle for secondary and tertiary sector. In this way, the burden of the economy will be distributed among the different family members. So when more people are working than required, it is known as the disguised unemployment. Coming to the structural unemployment, this kind of unemployment mainly occurs on the behalf of employers. Employers means the companies which are going to give jobs. If these companies do not offer proper job, it leads to unemployment. Assume in a year 1 lakh people complete their mechanical engineering, assuming that they will get a job. Now suddenly these mechanical companies have stopped hiring. They are not taking people. As a result, 1 lakh engineers are now unemployed. So here the companies which provide employment are not generating jobs. Such kind of unemployment is known as the structural unemployment. Now comes the cyclical employment. The unemployment that is created because of depression in an economy, it is called cyclical unemployment. Now this kind of unemployment can, or you might see in the coming days because of this COVID-19 crisis. Now as there are no production, the company will not produce any products as there are no buyers. So now as there are no buyers, there are no producers, people will not have sufficient money to buy things. So when the money is short, obviously people will not buy things, and if people are not buying, companies will not produce. So if companies are not producing, then they will not employ people. So the unemployment coming out of such kind of arrangement is known as cyclical unemployment. The last kind of unemployment which we are going to see is the frictional unemployment. In this kind of unemployment, the jobs or the people transfer from one job to another in a certain period. That means they don't stick to a job. They keep on changing their job profile from one job to another job. This switching disturbs their normal flow of income. It disturbs their experience, so causes harm to the person who is undergoing this frictional unemployment. So as we have completed the topic, now we will have a quick revision of all the main concepts which we have read earlier. So unemployment can be divided into 5 types: seasonal, which depends on season; disguised, when more than required number of people are working; structural, when the employers or the companies are not providing job; cyclical, where unemployment is arising because of loss in economy of the country; frictional, where a person cannot stick to a particular job for a long time. Now, how do you define unemployment? When a person is willing to work but he cannot find a suitable job, such a condition is known as unemployment. And India has a huge number of unemployed people till now. Though government is working hard to solve the issue, but we see again and again the unemployment cases are rising. And then according to the sectors, so we have two kind of sectors when it comes to job: organized sector and unorganized sector. So in unorganized sector, the job is given according to the government rule. All the government procedures are followed in that job. For example, you are given ID card, you are given proper salary, monthly salary, you are given proper allowances like for transport, for your accommodation. All such allowances are properly given, everything is well documented, you are given a salary slip, you have a right to take leave, take holidays. So everything is given according to the government criteria. Such kind of sector is known as the organized sector. Then another sector is the unorganized, that means which does not follow any government rules. For example, the person who has employed a boy in a pani puri stall, that boy is not given any proper ID card or any pay slip for his salary. He might not even get sufficient amount of salary or daily wage. He cannot take leave. He is not permitted to take leave whenever required. He has to work under a very difficult condition. His payment is less. Sometimes he may not be paid and he cannot complain because those sectors do not come under the government policy. They don't follow the government rules. So such kind of jobs comes under the unorganized sector. So moving back, we also saw the classification on base of ownership, that is private sector and public sector. The companies which are owned by private or group of individual or a person is known as the private sector. Example, Vodafone, then Tata Industries. Then we have public sector, which is owned by the government. Government runs these kind of companies, so those comes under the government sector. For example, RBI, Reserve Bank of India, and Air Asia or Air India. And economy is mainly divided into three sectors, which is the primary, secondary, and tertiary. Primary sector is also known as the agriculture sector. Then secondary sector is also known as the industrial sector, and tertiary sector is also known as the service sector, as it joins both primary and secondary. We also saw about GDP, which is the gross domestic product, the total of output of all the sectors in a year is known as GDP. So friends, I hope you would have understood the topic clearly. Until next time, take care.